them.
Our knowledge has made us cynical, our cleverness hard and unkind. We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity. More than cleverness, we need kindness and gentleness. Without these qualities, life will be violent, and all will be lost.
In traffic, I got a lot of stickers in my Jeep, more on the outside, but I'll give you guys a little sticker history. That would have been one of the first stickers I put on my Jeep when I first got it. I would not have put that on now. That I got with my ex-girlfriend. That was from my other ex-girlfriend. That's probably one of my favorite stickers though, I love it. That is from my homie Franny. If you see this, Franny, you're the best. That I got from my mom because she's a member of the human rights organization place. And I have one on the outside of my car too. And dude, let me tell you, having a sticker that advocates for equal rights really pisses people off. So weird. I think my sister got me that, Hannah. Thanks, bro. Pretty sure. Or I stole it from my dad. I can't remember. That is one of the oldest stickers that I've had on that Jeep. This Jeep, probably for all 4 years I've had it. The Yeti coolers. Wow. That actually came from when I was a lifeguard at the Parker Rec Center. This girl, I don't know, she was like a friend's friend of a friend, and she like overheard me talking like at my lifeguard stand about I love Yeti coolers or something, and I want to buy one just for their cool stickers that come with it. And she went and found me a Yeti sticker and brought it to me, and it's been on ever since. I'm driving, so this is like super hard and probably dangerous. That far one, Dive Belize, got that one. That's where I got certified to dive. Let me tell you, prime. I shouldn't even be putting it out there because I don't want anyone else to go spoil the beauty of Belize and its diving, because no one really knows how amazing Belize is. But I mean, honestly, the Blue Hole's way overrated, and it's super expensive just to see a bunch of tourists all doing the same shit. So go to Belize, though. It's amazing. That octopus, that's from Mina. I love it. Grip Royale on the far end. That's from Coco, too, back in high school, I think it was. Maybe right after. He gave me that sticker because, Coco, if you see this, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you got a sick steering wheel, and it came with a sticker for the company, so gave it to me like a bro. That's all, folks. We are out of traffic. Check out the habitat. It's changing. In Pueblo, we're about a third of the way there, filling up the old gas station. I'm sure like half of the people watching this have seen that same gas station, but after that we're gonna stop to fill up our tanks in another town, not just the Jeep tank, the spare tanks too, because then we're going out into the bush, mate. Filled up for the last time. We are gonna be civilization free after this, hopefully. And then by the time I get there, it's about 5 p.m. now, it'll probably be almost dark, so I'll probably start hiking. It's gonna get cold tonight. It's still, you know, spring in Colorado, so it'll probably get down to like 40s, but I'll probably hike for an hour or two. The snakes are still should be under rocks. I don't really know though. I just want to get out. Up here, I don't know what it is. Could be a coach rattlesnake, bull snake. Nice. It's a sexy little bull snake there, huh? Nice. I'm gonna grab some camera pics. That's funny. This is right about the same spot. I cruised a king snake a few years ago. And we thought it was gonna be a bull snake just like that. Got me. Be free. Look at him. Hating me. Well, fuck. This is why I move snakes off the road. Fuck. This racer is still alive and he's gonna die. Misery. And a viewer discretion card in this goddamn video. It's so sad. Got another dead racer. That blows. That thing is gorgeous. I mean, that's prettier than the one that was dying. Woo! All right. It's getting shaky. I don't know where I am. I'm really just trying to get down to a canyon. We're just shimmying along. Woo! I kind of like what I see. Don't get a flat tire from all those nails around though, so I'm gonna hop out and flip just for a sec here. Little baby tarantula. Look how cute he is. Hey. Buddy, what are you doing?
Why is he so scared?
Look how little he is. God, I love that. Okay, so sun's going down here pretty soon, but I'm just stopping around wherever I can, flipping. No snakes yet, but we got a shed, what looks like a ground snake. One of our targets, hopefully we'll see a live one. Alright, so got the first snake flipped. Stunner ground snake, stunner. Look at that guy, tiny little juvie under this rock. Tried to get the flip clip, but he was swimming away real quick, so look at that. Go to your rock. Alright, a little worried that these guys want something. Like, seriously, there's at least 100 of them. And, alright, these guys are trying to, like, fuck with my car. Badger, a sick big badger, but he got off the road before I could get a video. But can't have an adventure without a badger, that's for sure. I'm really just, honestly, I don't really care about finding too many snakes at all. I just want to get out, and I think I'm gonna head down to some canyons, do some night hiking, go flip stuff. Because I don't want to sleep. Sleeping makes Ian sad. So Ian going to go hike at night. Flashlight, we're going to go do a little night hiking. This is just a quick pit stop. Stay strapped or get clapped, bro. This is such a dumb decision. Really, me going on solo herping trips is just a whole sequence of bad decisions, and sometimes there's snakes in between. You see that scary method abandoned trailer? Got to go flip around in there. Well, that's like the cutest thing I've seen in my entire life. Oh, look at his little face. He's just out hopping around, having a rootin' tootin' time. That's a baby kangaroo rat.
Hey. It's okay.
Ooh. Ooh, he's a jumper.
Yeah, that's what they do. They're like little kangaroos.
I'm really stoked to see if I can find a ring-tailed cat, whatever they're called. I think that would be sick, and I know they're out here, and they're nocturnal, so I'm going to stick around some rock ledges once I get down into the canyon, keep a lookout for them. I have absolutely zero expectations for finding anything. It's about 55 degrees. It's so fun being alone and scared. And God, that's bright. So it's about 12 a.m. Still don't want to sleep. I'm not gonna sleep. I'm gonna go. It's raining a little. It started to electrical while I was down in a canyon that's just overworked. So I'm gonna go to a different one and look for amphibians or maybe blind snakes. We'll see. I'm just gonna walk along the road. I think there's some rocks. It's all private on the sides, but there's been actually a blind snake recorded there like years ago, like 10 years ago or something. So I know they're there. At some point, so I can't see jack shit though recording myself, so I'll update you guys when I see something.
God damn it, that's crazy.
Isn't that wild?
What, that was here too? I've never even seen one on.
Yeah,
have you?
I haven't.
Or is this your first one since we cruised that one a
this
few years
my
ago?
Second one since we cruised the one. So I got okay. One a little bit further up, and I've gotten the one got ours.
Yeah, yeah. Wow, that's a speckled king snake, folks. That's a good one. It's like 60 degrees right now.
Oh, wild.
Dude. Wow.
We were calling it a night. We were going to head down because there's rain hitting the canyon lands down there.
I'm oh.
Like, gotta go check it out.
Dude. What are the chances?
Right?
Wow.
The old speckled king. What a sexy snake.
What's crazy is this is the second one found in like 3 days.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Who else is out here?
I don't know.
It's like Joey Kellner or something?
Did you see the Facebook group though?
No.
Someone found one on there.
Oh, is that why you guys came down here?
We were coming down here anyway. We were going to go look for threads.
Oh, okay.
But you know, threads are.
Yeah.
Threads. You only find them DOR in San Diego.
I found one. Yeah, that was funny. I really thought more people would believe it.
No.
Badger out there. Let him go. God, I always miss him. He was right in front of me. They really bound away quickly. This is my camp. Blanket. That's about all I need. It's a long day. So I did about 12 hours of driving. It's like 3 to get down here, and the rest just driving around to places looking for snakes. I can hear toads calling and frogs, maybe. I think I'm hearing green toads, which are sick. Hopefully we'll see one, but it's probably been 2 years since I saw a green toad. You need not drought, which is not what we have going right now. So I got some edibles. And we're gonna kick back, eat some beef jerky, read a book, do a little meditation, and I'll catch you guys in the morning. I'm awake. It's about 7:30. And we're gonna cruise our way to some new flipping. We'll see what we see. Stopped here to flip some tires on the way to the next spot. And look what I flipped. Big old Coachwhip. First one of the year for me. It's gorgeous. Got some red on him, got some caramel on him. He's got that banding. That is a nice snake. I'm stoked. It's only 8 a.m. I was not expecting anything. This guy's about, it's probably about 5 feet, 4.5 feet. But yeah, guys, I was not expecting anything. Look at that. What a beaut. What a beaut. Wow. He's doing the playing dead thing right now, so I'm gonna get photos while I can, because once he's warmed up, he's gonna bolt.
What a snake. That thing's gorgeous. See the Coachwhip. Oh, what a beaut. He's playing dead.
So guys, this is the fastest snake in North America, the Coachwhip, Western Coachwhip. Out here we get them red and caramel, everything in between. This guy is almost exactly in between. He's got like half caramel with some reddish tint. Red is my favorite. I mean, you can't beat a big red Coachwhip. I'm gonna let him go. I don't think he's gonna even go fast yet though, or hold a ground or anything. He's kind of a baby, but one of my favorite snakes. They're so smart. They're diurnal. They have those massive eyes for hunting and actually chasing down their prey rather than rattlesnakes, vipers, constrictors. They don't totally go out looking for their prey. I mean, constrictors to some extent. But these guys, they just use pure speed and power. So cool. He's so smart. He's just trying to decide his next move. If he should swing around and nail me in the face, take my eyeballs out, and then book it, or play dead. I don't know, buddy. What do you think? So epic. Love these things. You can also see on their tail, I mean, it looks like a whip. So, the old Western people, they would say that these whip you with their tail. So, hence the name Coach Whip. That is untrue. I mean, you might get whipped catching one, but that's just because they flail. We are at the flipping area. Just got to hike. Definitely not going to jump this fence. Certainly not. So essentially, we are going to flip this entire place upside down. Ethically. And we could see anything from ground snakes to night snakes, Coachwhips, rattlesnakes. I haven't seen long nose or king snakes here. I know they're here though. Huh. Little skin there. Snakes. Believe. Oh shit. Oh guys, check it out. Hey, look at that. That must be what just made that shed. An all white and black variable ground snake. How sick is that? Wow. Dude, it's been a minute since I saw black and white. Oh man, got the flip clip too. What are the chances? Sweet. We'll see what else we can turn up nearby. I mean, I'm not more than 5 minutes in, baby. Guys, I've never seen that variation in the hundreds of ground snakes I've seen, especially in Colorado. Just flipped that and I double flipped him with another black and white. It's insane. I'm gonna keep these ones at least like within the ones I find within like 50 feet of each other, just to show you guys the variation once I collect a few. Ground looks pretty good though. Shit. Well, I missed another collared lizard. He literally hid under my foot, and I lifted my foot, and he ran. But I got this fatty, real fat, scaloperus.
That's nice. Pretty common little guys, but it's cute. Be free. Okay, 5,000 rocks later, we have our next snake. A nearly all white variable ground snake. Look at that. Now he's not albino or anything. He's very normal. But ground snakes being not normal is their normal. I don't know of anywhere else in the world you could see one like this. This one locale, I've seen one other like this in my life. Still not very common though. Sweet. Okay, under that rock. There it is, baby. Target market for this pit stop. This little exploration was this guy, the night snake. It's Hypsiglenia something. I don't remember the subspecies here, but God, you gotta love them. This is a pretty pale one, which is cool. They've got these sick head markings. Oh, yes. I knew I wouldn't get it on film because, this is seriously about my probably 200 or 300th rock. I was just about to call it. Because it's starting to get drier the further away I go from my car, but nice. This is a big one, too, at least for Colorado. Check it out. Some awesome little ground snakes from today. That little baby, all white, black and white. Awesome one, that's my favorite by far. That's sick. I went ahead and left that spot pretty quick as I was photographing the night snake. I saw farmers like a mile away, like half a mile away probably, in my Jeep. They were rolling up on a four-wheeler and they were checking it out, like getting out, taking pictures of it. So I went over there and they're actually the people that take care of the state trust land. So they just told me that I can't be on that land like without permission. So I didn't know. There's no signs like anywhere down here. You don't know what's private, you don't know whatever. So it's pretty much like a 50% chance wherever you go someone's gonna be butthurt about it. But they were cool once I explained. But it did cut me short. It's getting hot anyways, so I'm gonna do some cruising and then I might head northeast for Massasaugas before it gets too late. Look at these bears. I found a whole pod of grizzly bears. So menacing. I gotta go in there, guys. Come on. Phil? Hey, watch it, Bill. Kevin? Booty's looking nice today. Hey, Linda. I knew you were always the stupid one. Well, we're almost into the area we want to be in during prime time, but it's only 2:30, so never too late to do a little target sesh. Disclaimer, I do not recommend these headphones. They're just for music, but probably better than nothing.
Hey there, my name is Ian Breland, and this is my masterclass. Oh, baby, that's good.
Definitely can fix that. I'm gonna save it. Use it as a water bottle.
honest and it's true as bomb. I must admit that it feels like I stole it all. Here I go with the flow, living life like a snowman. On the road doing shows, never knowing when my moment will come. It's the devil I know, it's been cold so I'm okay, living like a snowman.
Guys, this one's a heartbreaker. Oh,
the first snake in hours and a still twitching, beautiful, dead Massasauga. And you know the worst part? He was killed because of me. Not by me, but because of me. I was driving down this road, cruising for the fifth hour, and this truck at the house this way down there starts speeding by after me, and they pull up and they ask like if I'm lost, because I've done at least 10 passes by their house, their ranch, in the last few hours, and they must have hit this on the way back from after I told them. Shit. Oh. Fuck, that blows. That is a gorgeous Massasauga, but that means they're out, so I'm gonna, oh, look at him, still opening his head. Guys, that is fucking tragic. Just about, oh, fuck, whew, just about hit that bull snake, and just about ate shit. Ooh, yeah, you mad. You mad, bro? That's cool. And I skid right by him. Alright, me and me go. Gotta get you off the road. Woo! Hey. Trick to getting them. Woo! Oh man, that almost nailed my face. He's headed this way. Usually you want to put them where they're going. Alright, you little shit. Hey. Be safe. I'm out of water and gas. That's all right though, because the whole idea is to slingshot ourselves back to civilization with these 5 gallons. It is 60 miles to the next gas station, give or take. I get about 8 miles to the gallon, give or take. The math almost works out. I'm hurling towards Colorado Springs. I have about 15 miles left. Can I do it? I put on about 600 miles today. Just herping. But we're home. Pretty successful, kinda, mostly. I mean, I wouldn't even call it a herping trip. That was just looking for snakes while exploring. It's mostly just like get out of my head trip, go do some good old fashioned solo adventuring. And we got some snakes in between. That Massasauga sucks, but I've seen them before and I'm gonna go back there. I gotta make that whole video anyways. Massasaugas are just, they deserve their own video. But we did good. I think that was like, I don't know, 4 or 5 species, not including the Massasauga. Not bad. Also, props Hunter and Sean. Did good with that king. Right place, right time. Very nice. So guys, I'm gonna call it a night. I'm pretty surprised I made it back, actually. The Jeep needs
a lot of shit done to it after this one. I mean, it always needs shit, but I think I tore my right side fender off more. I dented the back, accidentally backed into a big piece of metal, and the windshield cracked more, and the drive shafts, of course, are shaking, but that's a problem for tomorrow. Thanks for watching, guys. If you made it this far, let me know what you think or not. Give it a thumbs down or up or neither. Peace, guys.